here's the thing about an episode like the Tom Brady, which is the 8th episode of Preacher's 3rd season. It's a really good episode, and there were a lot of really good highlights, and I'm going to go over those in a minute. But as an episode in and of itself, it was kind of lacking simply because it didn't feel like its own episode. It felt like if you took the first half, you could have attached it to the previous episode, and I feel like the second half is a nice segue into the penultimate episode and into the season finale. I don't even really mean that as a bad thing, because depending on where the season goes, this could be that kind of episode that was really needed and necessary. If everything falls apart in the season finale, I might be revisiting this episode and marking it down some. So as an episode, I would kind of say incomplete at this point till I see how everything plays out. But in regards to from a viewer fan standpoint and the things we got, there were a lot of really great highlights to take a look at. So I want to start segueing into those now. Let me start off first by giving two people credit who have not gotten credit in my reviews in the past. Julie Ann Emery and Malcolm Barrett, Featherstone and Hoover, who really got some great opportunities to shine in this episode. The interaction between Featherstone and Tulip, I'll go on record as saying I would love to watch an episode of those two alone just going on a mission. They just have this great older sister, younger sister interaction and always wanting to one-up each other. I've mentioned in the past how much I love Featherstone's just unrequited love towards Herr Starr. But there's also her facial reactions in this episode just say so much without her having to say anything. I just the way she handles knowing full well at the very end of the episode that she knows Tulip has just basically screwed her over, not realizing exactly how much Tulip has screwed everybody over. Again, I'm a really big fan. And Hoover, just the voice of reason. I think in a lot of respects, Hoover represents us, the everyday viewer, and how we would be in the situation. But I also love the way he seemed to embrace and belong to Icarus's children of blood. And I'm really glad he made it at the end. But the fact that he was turned into a vampire, I did not see that coming. In fact, two big changes for their characters. The fact that we've got Featherstone making her way to hell, and if I was Satan, I'd be very nervous about that. And then we have a Hoover, a vampire, who then escapes at the end as we have the confrontation between Cassidy and Icarus. So, again, Emery Barrett have doing a fantastic job this season. They deserve a lot of props. I mentioned before about the Featherstone Tulip interaction. We definitely need to be seeing more of that. The manic nature of this episode, I could not get enough of. If you are a fan of the comic book, this is just going along. You have to be loving this. Not saying that it's faithful to the comic book, but when it's not faithful, it is still within, I think, the heart and the tradition of the comic book series. There are just so many over-the-top scenes. The idea of just what I call a crisis on infinite Humperdudes. They're constantly just genetically breeding new lineage of Christ until they get the right genetic cocktail to be able to inhabit Genesis. I just thought was just crazy. The idea of Jesse shooting Allfather and knowing full well if it's not a headshot, you know it's just not going to get anywhere. Just all of those scenes. Again, the Hoover becoming a vampire. There were so many things that happened in this episode and that just really, from a visceral standpoint, I loved. May not have been anything that was just dark and deep and dramatic, but it was just the kind of energy that I expect from Preacher, and it's what I want at this point, because I think it did a really great job in setting us up for what's to come in 9th and 10th episodes. Jason Douglas deserves props for as playing Satan. He's just killing it in this episode big time, and the fact that he just... It's interesting because I was wondering how Gran’ma Betty Buckley would interact with Satan, and that's exactly what I expected. Satan is Satan for a reason, and even she has to kind of take that step back when he's in the room, even though they are partners and deal brokers and deal makers. The Grail porn acting for the pseudo human resources sexual harassment presentation with Featherstone, Jody, and Tulip. I had to watch that over again. I just thought it was really fantastic, a major highlight. And the Tom Brady, the title itself, again, not going to super spoil it. Let's just say this. The perfect genetic combination to be able to house Genesis apparently is a combination of one of our founding fathers and someone who hosts a game show, who used to host a talk show, and who made a guest appearance on the Chappelle Show that is still classic to this day. So I love that combination. And also the talk of combining Serena Williams' DNA with Louis XVI. I thought some great over-the-top stuff that really, really sold the episode. My con, I would have to say, I was expecting more in the Cassidy Icarus situation. I really was, and I didn't feel like I got enough from it. I'm hoping we see more developments, because right now it just seems like it's chugging along in cliched path to Cassidy heartbreak, and I'm kind of hoping for more. But overall, great quality episode. We have some really good quotes. I want to get to them, five quotes that are definitely takeaways. Everything has a price, bitch. In Gran’ma Marie L’Angell's dream sequence, she hears that from Tulip. Go hump a duck or whatever you're into these days. Satan to TC. And it's interesting, I think TC even discussed Satan a little bit. Jesse Custer, you are most certainly a preacher. You are also a fool. Allfather to Jesse, and I guess we'll see how that plays out as to who ends up being the bigger fool in the long run. I just wanted to make you grab that guy's ass. Featherstone to Tulip. Again, that older sister, younger sister kind of like butting of heads. Just really, really good high point for the episode. And finally, human resources. Time to check your browser history from Jody. Spoiler, it's not the browser history he's checking. He's going to be checking their skulls with looks like a ball peen hammer. So, again, excellent episode. Quality across the board. Really looking forward to the final two episodes. Thank you for joining me. Can't wait for the next 2 weeks.